for?
Oh, this is Mr. Hornsby 83 with a, and instead of calling these things of indoor special, then you're gonna call them what they are, top 10, because that's what they are, top 10. So Mr. Hornsby 83 with another Mr. Hornsby 83 top 10. And I'm gonna start out with the GTA characters. I'll probably be doing a lot of GTA related videos up until the end of the month. I mean, since it's coming out in less than a week. So I'm gonna start out with number 10, which is 8-Ball. He was a real good friend to Clyde throughout the whole game. He, you know, his influence is all over all the GTA games, but with the exception of 4, which, you know, everybody knows my opinion on 4. But alright, number 9 is Tony Cipriani. The reason why he's not higher is because he was probably behind Salvatore putting the whack on Claude in 3, so I'm gonna go with Tony Cipriani right here. Alright, number 8 is El Boros. I think it was pretty a lot of the dialogue he had in the game, I mean, you didn't see him, but he was pretty funny, so number 8, El Boros. Alright, number 7, Misty. I mean, the reason why I picked Misty is because she is, you know, a pretty hot character for Grand Theft Auto 3. If you've seen some of the other women in the game, other than Maria. And she's also going to be in the online for GTA 5 along with Claude, which I wish they were able to be in the game, the campaign mode, but that ain't going to happen. Alright, number 6. This is number 6 right here. Number 6. Ricardo Diaz, and again, Ricardo Diaz, he's one of my favorite characters overall in the game. The only reason why he's not higher is because he did betray Tommy and Lance and all of them, but Lance also betrayed Tommy too. So, yeah. Ricardo Diaz, he was in Vice City and Vice City Stories, and he was very hilarious. I like when you first do his first mission for him, and he's like, yelling at all of his men, calling them to, you know, every cuss word in the book, and then threw something at one of his guys. It's just hilarious. And I was sad that I had to kill him in Vice City, but oh well. Number 5 is Umberto Rambino, also in Vice City and Vice City Stories. I really like Umberto because he's funny. And he's voice acted by my boy, Danny Trejo. So I wish maybe we'd see, you know, Umberto return in future editions of GTA, but probably not because of their 3D, 2D, 3D, HD situation. So, alright, number 4 is Sweet, Carl Johnson's brother, who really was a very proud man, really kept Carl's head straight. Got Carl thinking right again and all that in San Andreas. So, yeah. Alright, number... what was that? 5? 4? Alright, number 3 is Claude Speeds. The reason why I pick him is that 3 is because he don't talk too much. And he's, you know, he's not really that loyal, I guess because he got betrayed by Catalina, but who knows. Alright, number 2, and this was a tough one for me because, you know, I like both of these characters a lot. And I'm gonna go with CJ right here at number 2 because CJ, he was like pretty cool. You can build him up and all that. San Andreas, he's in one of my favorite Grand Theft Autos, a lot of people's favorite San Andreas. But yeah, CJ, he's a pretty awesome character, I think. I would like to see more backstory with him and what happened to him after everything with Tenpenny and that, but who knows. Come on, Rockstar, give us something. Some kind of game like that. Alright, number 1, the main man, who I think Michael will turn out to be at the end of 5, Tommy Vercetti. And the reason why I picked Vercetti over CJ is because Vercetti talks a lot of smack to cops, to other gangsters and everything. And Tommy was just, you know, a major league BA, just like the rest of the characters. And I know I have, but yeah, he's a major BA. I really think he was like, right now he's my number one. Who y'all think was better than the guys I picked? Maybe I should have took one guy. If you guys feel I should have took one guy off this list and put someone else there, leave it in the comment section below. Also, before I go, selling my big gold replica belt, and like I said, pretty nice in my review of it. Pretty nice belt. I mean, the only problems I have with it, me and my wife's mainly fixed. The strap still cracked. I was looking into getting it re-leathered, but really, I'm just going to sell it. I ain't going to no wrestling events anytime in the future right now because of a lot of problems going on, a lot of financial situations. But, that's why I'm giving it a range between anywhere between 200 and 300 because, like I said, me and wife did do a lot of repairs and put some money into it and fix the belt up to look nicer than what it was when I bought it. So hit me up on Facebook, my main Facebook page, not my fan page, my main Facebook page at Michael Hornsby. So tune in tomorrow night. I'll be doing another one of these top 10s. I don't know what it'll be about. I'll think it up tomorrow before I do the video. But until then, see you later. Peace out.